Hi, I'm Brian Boswell, an R&D engineer with Keysight Technologies, and I'll be demonstrating the PA2201 IntegraVision Power Analyzer today for measuring high crest factor signals. High crest factor signals are very common today in high efficiency signal generation, such as switching power supplies. Initially here, I'll be demonstrating the measurement capability by simulating voltage and current waveforms with a dual channel 33522 signal generator, outputting the voltage waveform as a simple sine wave and simulating the current waveform as a high crest factor signal with an arbitrary waveform. Run those into channel one, and you can see we have a normal sinusoid for the voltage channel and a very high crest factor for the current waveform. If you remember, crest factor is defined as the ratio of the peak to RMS value of the signal. The PA2201A can actually measure crest factors of up to 3 on a full-scale signal. This, coupled with the 16-bit A to D, allows very high fidelity signals to be measured without upranging of the channel. So as you can see on this particular setup, that I am actually measuring the current waveform on my 2-amp range, and I have a full-scale 2-amp signal with a crest factor of 2.985, right at a crest factor of 3, and you can see that on the waveform as the signal just crest at 6 amps peak. We'll now change the setup, and I'll show how we do this with an actual circuit that we're measuring. I've reconfigured the system to be actually measuring a real circuit to demonstrate the high crest factor measurement capability of the PA2201. The circuit that I'll be measuring is shown here in this diagram. I'll be actually measuring with an input signal of just wall power with a switched output. We have the input characteristics are measured on channel one, both the voltage and the current. The output characteristics of this circuit we'll be measuring with channel two. And the actual circuit is nothing more than a full wave bridge rectifier with a 160 ohm resistor and a 40 microfarad capacitor as the load. A little analysis of this circuit will show that it's not a very good bridge rectifier. I've intentionally not put enough capacitance on the output such that we'll have a lot of ripple and be able to demonstrate the high crest factor current waveform on this. So I'll now turn on the power. The PA2201 started triggering, and it now auto-ranged, and you can see the signals that we're going to be measuring. On the top set of waveforms are the voltage waveforms, with the yellow being the voltage waveforms. Notice you'll see the full AC signal on the input and the rectified signal as the output signal. The middle set of traces are the current waveforms. Notice that the input current waveform is bipolar and the output is unipolar with the rectification that's going on. And finally, then we have the power, and you might say there's only one signal for the power, but there's actually two. The power is identical for the input and the output, and let me demonstrate that by just adjusting the offset a little bit, and sure enough you'll see the input and the output power are identical, as we don't have any loss in the system. We'll now take a look at the signals, show the crest factor. I'm measuring the output characteristics, so I have 130 volts AC with 127 volts DC. So indeed, we've got a lot of rectification going on. I've got 1.27 amps RMS. being dissipated in the 160 ohm load. And if you notice, I have about 87 volts worth of ripple on this output. So indeed, not a very good full wave bridge rectifier at all. And if you come down to the current, you can see I have about 2.6 crest factor on that current. And we'll now flip over and look at the efficiency of my full wave bridge rectifier. That pulls up my push button efficiency panel, and you can see that I have 107 watts of input power, and the output is 100 watts for a total efficiency of 93.66. I hope you found this presentation interesting and informative on the measure of high crest factor signals using the PA2201A. Thank you.